In this video, we will be seeing the different Golden Gate parameters that you can use. What are the different types of Golden Gate parameters and what are the different types of Golden Gate parameter files? So basically, there are two types of Golden Gate parameter files. One is a global parameter file and other is a runtime parameter file. Global parameter file, it basically stores the parameters for the entire Golden Gate instance. These are very few parameters which are common to the entire Golden Gate processes. All these parameters are stored in the global parameters. So this is an optional parameter file. If you want, you can have it, or else you can leave it aside. The next is a runtime parameter files, which is specific to the process. For example, these are the parameter files that are specific to your extract process, replicate process, or the data pump process, or even the manager process. Now let us see in depth of what are these global files and what are these runtime parameter files, along with some examples. So as you know, global parameter file is applied to all the processes, like whatever are the processes like extract process, replicate process. To all these processes, these global parameters are applicable. It is set when the manager starts. Whenever the manager process is starting, these parameters are set and it is residing in the globals directory. So there is a separate directory at the OS level known as globals, which is created. In this directory, this global parameter process file is set. Now, process parameters, as I said, the runtime process parameter are specific to each and every process, like extract process, replicate process, and the data pump process, or maybe the server collector process. So these parameters are set when that particular process is started. For example, when the extract process is started, it will use this parameters that is related to the extract parameter file, and it overrides the global setting. Whatever is the global setting that is there, it will override those parameters, and by default it resides in the DIRPRM directory. So there is a directory known as DIRPRM that is created, which will have this extract process parameters. Most apply to all the tables processed, but some can be at the table level. So most of these parameters are applicable to all the tables, or you can restrict them to few tables also. Now we will see what is actually the global parameter. It controls the common things which is common. It controls the things common to all the processes in the Golden Gate instance. For example, manager. By default, the name of the manager process is manager. If you wish to give a different name, then you can use this global parameter process to set manager serve name. So whatever is a different name that you want to give for the manager process, you can give using this parameter, and that parameter you can define in the global parameters process. And if you want to save it, you need to exit the Golden Gate software command interface, GGSCI. You need to exit so that you can save this globals parameter process. As I said, this is an optional process. If you want, you can use this parameter, or else you can skip it. Moreover, once the global parameters are set, you don't change them because they are common to all the processes. Now we will see what is the overview of manager process. What are the different parameters that you set for the manager process? As you all know, manager process is a process which controls the remaining processes like extract, replicate, collector, and data pump processes. So this is an important process that runs both on the source and target side. So we will see what are the different parameters that you use for the manager process. As you see here, first is the port number. It is a port number on which the manager process runs. It is 7809 in this example. Next is dynamic port list. You can give a dynamic set of ports using which your Golden Gate can run on those ports as well, right? And auto restart ER star. ER star is a wildcard which you are restarting. For example, if it is an extract process or whatever it is, each time the manager process is started, it is going to start that process as well. That is what is auto start. Auto restart extract, wait 2 minutes, retries 5. That means if you want to start any of the extract process, your manager process, whenever it is started, it will automatically start the extract processes also. And it is going to wait each time it starts the extract process, and if the extract process is not starting, it is going to wait for 2 minutes, and at maximum it is going to give 5 retries before it ends it, saying it is unable to restart by writing that to an error log, right? Lag report hours. Your manager process will keep checking the extract process if there is any lag. So every 1 hour, it is going to check the extract process if there is any lag. Lag info minutes. If there is a lag, if that lag is more than 3 minutes, your manager process is going to write an information in the error log saying your extract process is lagging by more than 3 minutes. And if that lag goes to more than 5 minutes, if your extract process is unable to extract the data from the source database for more than 5 minutes, your manager process is going to consider that alert as critical, and it is going to report an error in the error log file. So there is a Golden Gate error log file in which all these errors and informations will be deployed, or it will be written in it, saying if the critical minutes is more than 5, if the lag of the extract process is more than 5 minutes, then your manager process will write a error onto the error log. And obviously, purge old extracts, whatever are the extracts that are replicated to the target database and you no longer need it, you can purge it using this particular parameter. Now, in the next video, we will be seeing the overview of the replicate parameter files and extract parameter files.